Hello, ancient miniature enthusiasts everywhere. I have an unboxing and some impressions of some new miniatures, which I've never come across until recently. So the only thing that's better than receiving a new box of miniatures from a company that you know and love is perhaps receiving a new box of miniatures from a company that's new to you that you've never used before and only recently discovered actually exist. So incredibly, this is New Lines Design Miniatures, and I ordered these miniatures 7 days ago, and they've got all the way from the UK to here, the other side of the world, 7 days, which is incredible, because unlikely I would even get stuff sent from the East Coast to the West Coast at the moment in that time. So I was quite amazed to receive these today. I'm going to go through and show you what I've got. So let's get them all out first, and then we can go through them in order. What a heavy little box, this one. Great value they were. They're actually on sale for 25% off at the moment, only for a few days. That's till the end of February 2022. But looking at their website, they seem to do 25% off sales reasonably often, like a couple of times a year or so. So they come in at really good value, significantly cheaper than most other metal miniatures when they are on sale like that. And even when they're not, they're pretty good value. And the cost of postage was actually very reasonable, less than a lot of other companies. So thumbs up for value for money. Let's have a look at the quality of these guys. The other cool thing about them was that they do a whole lot of ranges of cultures that most big companies don't ever bother doing. So, for example, these guys are the Cappadocian Cavalry. So who else makes Cappadocians? I certainly haven't seen them from other companies. I may have seen one other company does a few, but anyway, these cavalry look quite cool. I like the horses. They're a bit chunky, but quite nice poses. You've got the barding on that that one, and a nice, really nice saddle there. Just, they do have a little bit of flashing on that need tidying up. I've made a start on some other cavalry, which I'll show you in a minute. It'll just take a few minutes to get them cleaned up. One little defect in one of the horses had a small cavity in it, but easily filled. Nothing drastic. And then these riders look really nice with their kind of chainmail or scale mail, I guess it would be, including their legs. So almost cataphract like. With oh, he's got a cloak too. Cool. This guy. Yeah, they're good. I think actually they are better than what I expected. I think the website has lots of photos. It doesn't actually have photos of all of their ranges, but the majority of them, and to be honest, they're not very well painted, so I don't think it kind of shows them in their best light. So I'm hoping once mine are done, they'll look better than they did on the website. Now here's, I've got a whole lot of Thracians because they look great. I've been wanting some nice Thracians for a while, and Aventine do some really good ones, but only a very small range, whereas this company seems to have a much bigger variety and range of Thracians than most others. There's a pack of six. Again, a bit of flashing that's got to be dealt with, but not too drastic. I think there's three different guys. Yeah, two of each, so I'll just have to modify them a little bit to get them all looking nice and unique. They're pretty cool little guys. It's slightly small on the slightly small scale. I'll put up some other comparisons in a bit and we can see how they go there, but they're kind of a little not as slim as the Ajima ones, but they look a little bit slight at first glance, but then when I've actually put them up against Aventine and others, there's not a big difference between them. Yeah, let's get all the Thracians going here now. Right, here comes another pack with the Romphias, big curvy, vicious little vicious swords. And they've all got cloaks, I really like them. I think they've all got cloaks, yeah. I like them with cloaks on. Nice. They're beauties. Nice shield attached to his back there. Shield on the back. Another shield on the back. Another cloak. They're going to be really cool. So those Thracians. Oh, I've got some more Thracians, I think, before we go to other cultures. Oh, yeah, two more lots of Thracians. Maybe I won't pull them all out of the packet, but these are very similar. The Romphias. What's the difference there? Oh, yeah, that must be the command pack, I think. So you've got a guy with a trumpet there. Another guy with a banner. Yeah. Trumpet again. Yeah, they're cool. So there's. Oh, and then I've got the Thracian cavalry as well. The Thracian crazy. I was going to get a small lot of other guys initially, but then I was really wanting some nice Thracians. I just saw 25% off. I'd be silly to miss the opportunity. Kick myself. So I went back and put a secondary order in. Delayed the dispatch for a day or so, but then, incredibly, got to the other side of the world in 7 days. So, pretty lucky. So, three horses. Again, they've got the slightly chunky feel to them, but I prefer that than too skinny. Now, Thracian cavalryman number one. Not much flashing on him to be dealt with. So with this 25% off deal, I think they're about half the cost per guy of the Aventine figures, which is remarkable. And there's not a lot of difference in quality. It's not like he's a poor quality. Oh yeah, I accidentally his trumpet was slightly bent and I bent it back and snapped it off. But anyway, that'll be easy to replace later on. So I think I'm going to get a nice little Thracian army out of that. I'll get these boys out of the way. There's one more who I've already pulled out of his packet there and tidied him up a bit. I'm very happy with them. They are cool. What else we got? I've got some Samnite cavalry. I haven't seen them around either. Don't know anyone else who makes... Oh, actually, I think Aventine do make Samnite cavalry. Couldn't resist cleaning him up and putting him on a base already. Oh, there's two others, whoops, but they're off also gluing, so I haven't got them to show at this stage, but I'll probably what I'll do is a series of little videos later with each of the groups and show how they look once they're all done. So a couple other little packs just to quickly show you, and I might actually give you a quick look at the website because it's got an amazing range of different cultures. So these, I've got some Greek Peltas as well. Always found the Greek Peltas that most companies make pretty boring and dull looking, so I've never been tempted to buy them, but these ones just looked a bit more interesting to me. And everyone's unique in this group, so you've got six Greek Peltas of everyone looking cool and quite different. There's a few capes, different helmets. Fairly dynamic poses. She's running, coming up the back there, and they've all got the nice crescent-shaped shields. There's a few spears. Where's the shields going? Nice shield. They're a bit smaller than, say, the Victrix ones or the War Games Atlantic ones, so you wouldn't probably be able to use the shield transfers that they make for their curved shields, but anyway, I think they're more interesting figures than, say, Victrix's Peltaster. Yeah, I like them. They're really good. And then, last but not least, is the Maccabean Cavalry, heavy cavalry. Another cultural racial group that's hardly ever covered by ancient miniature makers. It's the Judean Hebrew people. It's similar horses to the other guard. Three of them, and then the riders are nice. I thought actually I might actually use them as Carthaginians. Not having any other Maccabeans, I'm not feeling particularly up for building a Maccabean army, but if you were interested, they do have infantry as well. He's a nice guy, bareheaded. And the other one's the same, so you've got three guys there. So I'm very impressed, they're better than I was expecting. The scale's quite good, as I said, I'll just grab a couple other guys. Actually, let's get them right here. So I've got a Victrix horse, and the Victrix is always a little bit on the big side for horses. So that's a Persian horse. Put them together. It's not a not much of a difference, really. Obviously, very different poses, but should we look at the rump sizes of both? They're pretty similar. Head sizes. Victrix is a bit more elongated, but yeah, they're probably actually quite similar. So that's better than I thought. Let's have a Victrix individual versus one of these Greek Peltar. So yeah, again, they're not a big difference. There's obviously a big base on the Victrix guy. They're slightly smaller, like a few percent, maybe 5% smaller, but not a major difference. And then I've got the Aventine Etruscans that I've reviewed recently. Let's compare that with a Thracian from New Line Designs. Again, it's definitely a little bit smaller, a little bit shorter, a little bit slighter, but not a huge difference. You could almost get away with them in the same unit. Make them separate. Good, I will just go now and show you a little bit of the website, because it's pretty impressive the range of different stuff they've got. Right, so I won't spend a lot of time on this because obviously you can look at it yourself, but just to give you a quick demo. So they've got different ranges, 10, 20, 28 millimeter ranges, and some sort of fantasy ones as well. 28 millimeter. So you look at that, they've got ancients, but they've also got these dark age ones, of which many would be quite suitable for use in the ancients. You go to the ancients and they have all these different ranges that you don't seem to find. So they say the Cappadocians, the Maccabean Jewish, they've got all the main favorites like the Numidians and the Germans, the Greeks, but then they've got a big range of Indians, again the Romans, the Han Chinese, and then you've got some rare guys, like not a lot of Parthians are made. There's plenty of Samnites, Scythians, they're really cool. I think I might go for them next. Seleucids and the Thracians. So an excellent range of some of the out of the way sort of guys. And then I'll just show you some of those ones that are officially Dark Ages, which you could easily use for this era, ancient or classical era as well. Like, for example, where were they? Well, you could use some of the Arabs. Actually, maybe it was in the biblical ones that were more suitable for this. Babylonians, Assyrians. The Assyrians are nice. Nubians, yeah, they were the ones that I thought would fit in quite nicely here. Again, you see some of the ranges, they don't actually have pictures, which is disappointing. And you see they're still 25% off, but say Nubian infantry. Yeah. What nice figures. So anyway, I will leave it there. You can look them all up yourself, obviously, and I'll get to work and I'll do a series of little demos of these guys as I work through them. But so far so good. I think they're pretty cool and I'm excited to discover them. Righto, all the best.